I don't feel very confident here. Ah! Okay. It wasn't the best, but okay.
That's that. Sounds like you got another pack moving in, though. The Sabbat are going all out. You better head underground, avoid stray bullets.
Sounds like a good strategy. Yeah, I know, guys. It's gonna take me quite a bit to get used to the combat in here. It's very, I don't know, fast and kind of janky.
Go get the tire iron that shovel head dropped. You ain't gonna need it.
Oh, good idea. So now I'll be using melee weapons. Okay.
Quit dicking around. Get the fucking tire iron.
Ooh. Touchy. You have just picked up a tire iron. That's completely correct. To equip this weapon, press the melee weapons key F1 till the tire icon is highlighted in melee weapon inventory list. Stuff. This icon indicates the weapon that you currently have equipped. For ranged weapon, there are numbers indicating your current reserve of ammunition. Later on in the game, you'll find armor to protect yourself. Equip it in the same way as the weapons by pressing the armor key, F3, till the armor is highlighted, and then clicking the left mouse button. Okay, so F2, F3, okay, here we go. How do I change this? There we go. Cool. It was blocking. Which I failed to do. I think I tried to. Much prefer to first. Now whenever we that's unfortunate. Whenever we attack we go into third person. Oh well.
Alright, head down into the basement through the grate in there. Keep that tire iron handy. I'll be there in a minute.
Alright, see ya.
Go on. I'll be right here.
He's not touchy anymore, is he? Head downstairs into the building. Looks like... I thought I saw something in Quest Fail, no. Well, down there, obviously. Just looking around and stuff. Oh, what we got here? Oh, that's just for that. Okay. Can I use a toilet? Nope. I don't think vampires have to use the bathroom. What's going on here? Can't sneak? Oh, because I'm standing on it, I guess. There we go. Can I use the ladder, or we're just going to drop down? Dropping down. Got it.
Stop!
Combat is not the only solution for sticky situations. You can also use your feats and disciplines and dialogue. When you're able to do this, your responses will show up in the different colors, and we're using higher resolutions, different fonts that are indicated below. Okay, so yeah, domination, red, persuasion is blue, seduction is that purple script, and then intimidation is green. Now, we're good at domination and intimidation. Although I'm assuming in this point with the tutorial, anything would work.
You! Just stay back. Keep your distance.
How about not?
Now, who the hell are you? You involved in all this? Because I'm going to raid this in, and SWAT will be all over this place.
Okay. So we can dominate. Tell him you will show me the way out. Basically, like, using the force. Kind of. Blue is persuasion. No, but if SWAT comes, they'll drive the gunman down here. You want that? This is seduction. Most men don't fear me until it's too late. Wow, smart and sexy. And then, Green is intimidation. Maybe I am. And maybe my fun isn't over just yet. You know, I'm not going to be able to use seduction, I don't think, that much. Or persuasion, for that matter. So I'm going to use it in this case. Just have some fun. Most men don't fear me until it's far too late. Wow, smart and sexy. I wonder if it'll work.
Thank you? Look, lady, I don't know what you want, but I'm not about to take a bullet for this job.
Just show me the way out.
Yeah, okay. Alright, this way. This'll lead us up to the warehouse. We can maybe sneak out that way.
I guess that's a success. Go ahead. Am I automatically following him? Is that Jack? My humanity's lost? Ah, damn it. I led him into danger. Well, I didn't know danger was there. Alright, so, yeah, I lost a dot of humanity. So I guess I should have told him to stay there. When you're in position to perform a stealth kill, you will see this icon. Stealth kills have the advantage of being silent. To perform a stealth kill, equip your fifths or a melee weapon. Crouch and sneak up behind your victim until you see the stealth key icon, then press the use key. When you're on higher levels, higher stealth levels, the attack key. I wonder why the difference. So, do we see it? Now we see it. Okay, that was not Jack.
Not sure what's going on. Sounds like the Sabbat's getting scattered. I'm gonna keep an ear to the ground. Be careful going forward here. Could be a whole mess of them holed up.
Great. Just my luck.
Go on ahead, just keep it down.
Literally. Is there anything up here? Can I jump up here? Disciplines are your vampiric powers and cost a certain amount of blood from your blood pool to activate. An innate ability common to all vampires is blood heal, which heals you. This icon indicates the power you currently have selected. There are two types of disciplines, passive disciplines that directly affect you, and targeted disciplines that directly affect your enemies. Blood buff is another ability common to all vampires. Oh, okay. Scroll the mouse wheel to detect blood buff and use the power key to activate it. Right click. Okay. Blood buff gives you a temporary bonus to all of your physical attributes. It is useful in a variety of situations, like picking a lock that would otherwise be too difficult. Note, in Elysium areas you can use blood buff while picking a lock only. They want me to be using blood buff? Is that what? I hear people walking out there. How do you switch through them again? Disciplines. Use discipline. Next discipline. Mouse wheel up and down, okay. Blood strike, command, blood buff. Lock difficulty of 3, not bad. So now I can open it even though I'm sneaking. Oh, seriously? Tremere have three unique disciplines, thaumaturgy, vampiric blood magic, auspex, second sight that allows you to see the auras of others, dominate, the ability to bend people to your will. Auspex gives you the ability to see people's auras. The aura color indicates an individual's disposition. It also increases your perception, important to both the range combat and inspection feats. So I'm not using range combat right now. Not a masquerade violation. Now, I could use that, but I know he's right behind that, whatever that thing is. It's like a generator or something. There's a guard up ahead. Use auspex to see his aura through the machinery. Okay, we're going to use auspex. Scroll the mouse wheel to select auspex and use the power key to activate it. Remember, it's a passive discipline. Make sure to pay attention to the discipline timer on the bottom right of the screen. Once you see the guard, equip the tire iron, move forward, and kill him. Alright, so I could do that. I could cycle through, or I could just press my 5 key. Or not. It wants me to cycle through only. Ah! This is very difficult. Okay. I'm out of blood. Can I feed on him? Oh, he's a vampire. So I really, yeah, auspex is really weak to begin with. I couldn't see him until he was basically on me anyway.
No need to go stirring up the hornet's nest till we know the score, though. Head through here and come to an elevator around the way.
Alright, elevator. I'll meet you over there.
Meet you there. Don't let them catch you.
If I'm not there in 10 minutes, call the president. I need blood. Blood, man.
Go on ahead. Just keep it down.
Keep it down. I didn't want to use auspex. Cool sound. This is something I can hack into. There's somebody out there. I don't have it. I don't have the blood right now for this. Thaumaturgy is sorcery that can bend blood to powerful and terrible ends. It's a targeted discipline. The effect and its length varies with each level. It's a masquerade violation. There are two guards ahead. Use thaumaturgy to incapacitate and then kill them. You have level 2 thaumaturgy known as Blood Purge. Scroll the mouse wheel to select Blood Purge. Move nearer to the guards and use the power key to activate the discipline. It's an area of effect discipline. Both guards, being fairly close together, become violently ill. Equip your tire iron and kill them. Can I even use it, though? I have hardly any blood. Blood purge. Here goes nothing.
Oh, yeah.
Nope, didn't work, because I'm going to die. You've used your entire blood pool. Conserve blood for when you need it. Low blood pool means you're hungry and run the risk of frenzy, loss of control. Fortunately, there's no one to feed upon around here. There's just more of these guys. Yep. Okay, they give me more blood, so I can actually use the blood purge. Well, I'm on auspex. This is very disconcerting.
Oh,
Oof. This will get easier soon. I'm not going to be using melee weapons, or especially not unarmed combat. I'm going to be staying away from people as much as possible. So I wonder if there's any goodies up here. Get me out of this. I have this view here. Can I jump up here? Apparently no. Almost. But not quite. Anything else to step on? No. Nope. Alright. Well, I got past that. Dominate is the vampiric power to bend others to your will. How much blood do you think I used it twice, you see, because the other guy was up ahead. I couldn't get them both. So I had to use Blood Purge twice. The effect in this length varies with each level. Use of Dominate is not a masquerade violation. There's a guard up ahead. Use Dominate to incapacitate him and pass by. You have level 1 Dominate known as Command. Scroll the mouse wheel, select Command, place your cursor over the guard, and use the power key to activate Discipline. How close do we have to be to use that? The guard will be diverted, you can then walk past him. I prefer to do things like that. Command! Pick up an object and throw it, you will see this use icon. Thrown objects make noise, can be used to distract your enemies. Oh, that's cool. There's a Sabbat vampire up ahead, guarding the exit. Crouch, find an object you can pick up, and throw it away from the guard to distract him. Once he is away from the exit, sneak through the room and leave. Alright, wish me luck. Where is he? Hit the...
Fucking humans. Gangbangers protecting their turf. Aw, man. I'm here thinking it's Sabbat moving up in here. It's the fucking locals about to take one for the hood.
Really? So what do we do?
They probably seen too much. Here, take this .38. Fucking pea shooter, but a few shots in it will take down a human.
Sweet. That's more my style. Thanks.
Well, I'm gonna want it back, so don't go die and lose it. I don't use guns much. They're noisy, they're clumsy, practically useless against vampires, but still.
What a shame.
Kindred's gotta keep up with the times. And in modern-day Los Angeles, that means coming strapped.
Useless against vampires?
Well, yeah, some are more lethal than others, of course. Watch out for those shotguns. Ouch, those things can smart, I tell you.
He did say a vampire can be killed by a shotgun to the face. So I hear you.
Head up and clear out what's left of them. Can't have them running their mouths about any of this. I gotta make sure there's no stragglers around outside.
Okay. You have just been given a .38 revolver. To equip the .38, press the range weapons key, F2, until the revolver icon is highlighted in your range weapon inventory list, and then left click. To fire, press the attack key. Some weapons, but not the .38, have an alternate firing mode, such as automatic fire. Press the attack mode key to toggle it. Okay. Range combat is a combination of perception and firearms. It's a feat that affects how well you shoot a gun. When you equip a gun, you will see the range combat cursor, its spread, and the speed at which it focuses is a direct result of the value of your range combat feat. There are some bottles on a crate at the end of the hall. Aim your cursor, wait for it to fully focus, and use the attack key to fire the gun. Okay, so we can practice on the bottles first, I guess. Oh, yeah, okay. Is that a... I could use that rat. There's a bottle in the crate at the end of the hall. Aim your cursor, wait for it to fully focus, and use the attack key to fire the gun. Where are these? They're here. So I can feed for... Oh, it's not going to let me forward. Damn it. F2, right? Okay, so I have it equipped, I'm guessing. Here we go. Well, I don't want to use up everything. I want to feed... Where'd the other one go? It ran? Oh, it ran over here. You didn't like seeing your friend get fed on, huh? Oh, you're next. Mmm, tasty. Oh, so tasty.
Go on up. I'll meet you.
Alright, stand by, guys. Okay. I'm gonna shoot some peoples. Oh, what's this? Oh, got more rounds. A speed loader of 638 rounds for your Saturday night special. Incoming! Oh, I changed to my weapons. Okay. He said I'm going to the elevator, right? Yeah. Resolution too low. Cannot read. We're in the basement, I'm guessing. Yeah, so we want ground. Gonna shoot some people? Are they in here with me? Oh, I got a baseball bat from him. Once the signature crack of this equipment conjured images of America's pastime, now it has evolved into the brutal chorus of a thug song. The tire iron, heavy metal blunt, could be used for fixing a flat, sure. No weapon readied. So let's look at this. Melee combat requirement 3. Damage potential 10. This requires more. Damage potential is the same. Lethality 7 versus 8. Feat adjustment. So this does have a little bit more lethality, but I'm going to be worse at using the baseball bat than I am the tire iron. Colt Police Positive Special. This is a cheap, small caliber handgun used by startup hoods and alleys across the country, also known as a purse gun. Okay. You should have something as well. Well, I guess more ammo for this.
That's it, kiddo. Just like that, it's all over. Everyone slinks back to their corners of the city for the night.
To experience. That's it. It's all over.
Until the next night, when the Camarilla finds some way to strike back. Parry, dodge, spin and all that, and so on, and so on, and so on.
So, this is normal?
Well, to be honest, you came at a, an interesting time, let's say. The Camarilla, the Sabbat. In L.A., these are the new kids on the block. There's already plenty of kindred had stakes down in California long before them. Now, we got every ancient kindred rivalry playing out all over the city. A lot of tension out there. A lot of fear. A lot of jittery, high-strung predators clinging to their little pieces of eternity.
You're losing me here, Jack.
Oh, boy. I think they're looking for you outside. Guess you got a cab to catch. Was hoping to fill you in on a little bit more, but... hell, you'll figure it all out.
I will? Ooh. So I can try to use... What is that? Persuasion? Blue is persuasion. I will, but I would like to keep the gun.
If you make it back, stop in at the last round. It's this bar downtown here. I'll fill you in on the politics. Now that's the stuff that'll kill you. Good luck.
Is he letting me keep it? He didn't mention one way or the other. I'll see you there after I get a good day's sleep. You have received 2 experience points. By pressing the character editor key, you can access your character sheet and spend your experience points where you see fit. Unspent experience points will stay in your available experience pool. Prince Lacroix has arranged for you to use a Camarilla safe house in Santa Monica as your haven. Here you will find some essentials such as your computer for emails to serve as your base of operations, I believe it said. Alright, so character sheet. And then I'm going to call in an episode. Change it to this key. Okay, so I have 2. So let me guess. I can't get another in computer. No. I can get something like... Well, not even. Oh, it tells you if you can use... Yeah, I don't have anything. Yeah, I don't have enough to increase anything at this point. Otherwise, it would have in parentheses. Wherefore art thou, Mercurio? Prince Lacroix dictated that you were to meet with an agent of his named Mercurio in Santa Monica, who will provide you with the details of your assignment. Just like that. It's all over. So, I really look forward to checking out everything, guys, in this room and beyond, and meeting this Mercurio. Just bear with me with the combat aspects. I know I'm not that great at it, but I think the thaumaturgy is going to help me a long way, and I'm going to get used to it as time goes on, of course. So, thanks so much for watching, and see you in the next episode, and always seek adventure and blood. Always seek blood.